10 months of negotiations and still no result. Now the Union for Teachers is acting. Job sanctions were announced this morning.
So yeah, we recognize that parents are going to be inconvenienced, and in the mornings, especially with some supervisory duties that that occur in schools and after the school day. And yet at the same point, we know that this is an important issue, and teachers voted 90.2% in favor of doing something in order to meaningfully address this, and government still refuses.
Teachers will arrive no earlier than 15 minutes before the school day starts and leave 15 minutes after it ends. That means no extracurricular activities.
Well, I can't play sports anymore if that happens. Pretty disappointed about that.
This will affect us because our basketball team is ranked first in the city right now. And if this happens, cities is on Thursday and the strike starts on Thursday. So if this happens and we get to the finals, we will not be able to play in the finals.
I think there's people have a right to strike. People should have the right to stand up for their jobs, and that unions are justified.
Teachers in Saskatchewan haven't had a contract since August last year. The two sides were bargaining as recently as last week. One major sticking point has been class sizes, which was brought up in the legislature today.
They've chosen to walk away from those conversations and not return to the bargaining table, and so we're disappointed.
Our classrooms are overwhelmed, our teachers are standing up for our kids, and he accused them of walking away from Saskatchewan children. Here's the guy who has presided over cut after cut in our education system.
No further bargaining meetings are scheduled between the two parties at this point. Meanwhile, students and parents prepare for changes at school and wait for the two sides to find a way forward. Alicia Bridges, CBC News, Saskatoon.